Welcome to the Circle NYC After Show. I am your host, John Malik, born and raised in Harlem, New York, and I'm here to set it off this season. First up, we have our infamous return of Mr. Melli B.
Hey, guys.
Welcome back.
You know, there's no show without Melli B.
That's what I hear. We have not met yet, but I'm
a huge
fan of the show.
You didn't say it. You said of the show.
Let me get there.
Okay, go ahead.
We're going to get there. I am a huge fan of the show, and you were one of my favorite characters for a multitude of reasons.
Okay, good.
I feel like you're like the Kenya Mora of the Circle NYC.
I would say that.
Do you think that's because of your presence before you even walk anywhere, or?
Apparently, that's the thing. It was hard to kind of receive what was happening because I've been through now 2 seasons of everybody against me.
Right.
And it takes a certain type of person to come back to that at any moment.
Right.
Who wants to walk into a situation knowing it's going to be war against everybody?
Yeah.
You know, versus it just happening. Bitch, I expected it. But
right.
That doesn't bother me because that's my real life.
Right.
I go through it with anybody on the streets, anyone in business. Confrontation is okay with me. It's not something I want to do.
Mm.
I'm absolutely comfortable doing it.
But you don't mind it.
I don't mind it.
I think at the end of the last season, we saw you move from New York to Atlanta.
To Atlanta, yeah.
So how has that been?
Atlanta has been great. I mean, as you can see, I got the horses in the bag.
It's the gay mecca. Like, so where in Atlanta are you?
So I'm in College Park now. I was downtown. I'm in College Park now because my horse is in Stockbridge.
Why get a horse?
I've always loved horses. I've been riding a horse since I was little.
Where you from originally?
So I was born here, but I was raised in Rochester.
Okay, so then that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay,
no, I'm not no Harlem bitch. I got on a horse bitch out of nowhere.
So, you're in Atlanta, and you're loving it.
I love it. It's beautiful black people, beautiful Latino people. Everybody is just kind of, not saying on a certain level, but there's a certain level of consciousness, and they pay attention to what's happening. They're
right.
just not here living.
That's
like
how
a lot
feel.
Of these bitches.
That's how you feel.
Yeah, they just rolling with the flat tires, bitch.
Who is this?
Honey, a lot. It's four. Whole thing is rolling, bitch.
We're gonna get into that. So then, production calls, you're back.
Now, I was happy I got to show the Atlanta side.
Right.
I feel like when I filmed the other past 2 seasons, there's a lot of major shit that I do that I don't talk about.
So you spend time in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. So what are you looking forward to when you come back to New York?
So being back in New York, I don't know if it's redemption that I'm seeking.
Right.
Ooh, that makes it sound good.
That
but
sounds good.
I feel like, because who I was on season 2 was crazy. Everybody had an issue with me being ready to fight everybody and doing all of that. I told bitches to their faces I would fight them.
Right.
Literally.
Right.
And season 2 happens. I'm not the type of person that if I have love for you, if something was to go wrong, the only way that I could fight you is if you was to touch me.
Right.
Like, I'm not going to come for you if I once had some type
See, you don't get the assault charge.
I'm not that girl. I don't play that. But, and then on the other hand, I want to try to find a way to connect with somebody.
Right.
Like, I want to
right.
have a moment. I've never had a moment where it was another cast member and we liked each other.
Right.
And we did something together and liked each other and it wasn't them talking about me or me talking about them.
So we got a lot to look forward to from you this season.
Absolutely. I'm definitely coming back.
Do you think it's going to be as dramatic as previous seasons?
It's going to be
worse.
It's going to be worse because I gave the wrong impression season 2.
So everybody's already coming in with
yeah,
these
everybody
kind of
every season is who can take Melli B. It's like fucking Hunger Games.
Mm.
Yeah. And the odds are never in their favor.
Well, my hope is that you find a comrade.
Me too. I wish you were on the show. I feel like we would get along.
We would get along.
Okay, good.
So, let me ask you one of the burning questions from everybody is why did you leave the reunion?
Well, so when I came into the room, a lot of the presence and what I saw was of me, an extension of me. Lambda Vodka being there, all these people I've connected, all these people I help incorporate their businesses.
Okay.
And so I don't feel like I'm entering a room that is fair versus a stranger seeing me come into a room versus people who know me, who are calculated, and they have this weird, just bad energy that they want to, everybody want to touch me.
Yeah.
And to, you know, I came with a bodyguard, obviously. I came alone. They all come with, the whole families was in the audience. I mean, like, everybody that was sitting in the front row. That was everybody that wanted a piece of me. Mm-hmm. And so, I still walked into the room. Let's be clear. I could have one bodyguard all day. It's still 30 of you bitches. You don't think at some point, if something go down, I'm definitely tapping on half you bitches?
Right.
I will be. I will not be alone, but at least I'll have... I ain't got time for that. But so
you said I might not throw all the licks.
Yeah,
but
so it's like I was sitting there. I hadn't said nothing yet. Mm-hmm. All I was doing was sitting there. They couldn't even fucking take that. I was minding my business. They was trying to taunt the, you know, bodyguard and stuff. And I feel like they didn't want me to talk. Mm. They didn't want the real conversation to happen because I'm not gonna.
As an audience member, I think that's what was so unfortunate because I feel like a reunion is a time and a place for you.
Let's put it all on the table.
Period. Let's tell the truth. Let's honestly talk about it and come to like resolutions.
Yeah. And I caught a flight for that. So I wanted that to happen. I even hired a bodyguard so that way the bodyguard wasn't for me. It was for them. Oh. Bitch, if I have to tap your ass, it's different. You have to peel me off a bitch. A bodyguard, I ain't got to peel.
He's just there to break it up.
Yeah, bitch, he there to do what he do. Girl, right. I don't have that kind of training. Right. I'm just going to wear you out. And so, you know, with that being said, I came there with intention on being able to say what I needed to say. It was all facts. It was all truth. So filming in Atlanta was great because I was able to film with, like, my family, my god kids, and people that I actually fuck with in real life. And I got to show a side of me that you would never see because every time I come into a room, bitch, it's World War III.
Right.
Ooh, I'm rhyming, bitch. But,
So you have family there?
Yeah, so my god kids are there. Like, my best friends all moved there. My friends of, like, 10-plus years, and so...
See, I thought when at the end of the last season, I was like, oh, he's just moving to a foreign country.
Yeah. No, I lived in Atlanta before. With the gays. No, I lived in Atlanta before I was engaged, though.
Gotcha.
And so I didn't get to do Atlanta. I was, well, he thinks I did Atlanta. I didn't do Atlanta, like how I'm doing Atlanta now, bitch. But,
and Atlanta is like notorious for web series and things like that. And what brought you back to the Circle NYC?
Well, a few of them contacted me. One of them wanted me to audition. I was like,
I'm Melli B. I don't
audition. It's a whole fucking 3 seasons in a row. And I wanted to do it, but I was like, I can't do that. But then another show, they were interested as well. But Nunu is different. Nunu is a one person doing better than them with an entire team. And how do you compare?
Right.
And so...
And there's a familiarity there.
Yeah, there is. But it's unpredictable for me. I never know what the fuck is going on.
So, to close out this session, I'm going to give you each person's name, and you're going to tell me each cast member's thought that first comes to your head. Okay.
The first thing? Shit, or what, the second?
I take the first, because it's the honest one. All right, so let's start with John.
John. So John and I, we've actually gotten really close supporting each other outside of even on the show and stuff like that. John does his own thing, and he's driving the car down, and he's speedy, bitch. He does what he wants, period. This bitch is doing the most. She got a neck brace on.
Dwight.
Me and Dwight... It was a little compromised at first, but we're close now. We spent some time together in Atlanta. With Dwight, you can look forward to. He's super vulnerable and open. He does not mind.
You already knew him prior. Somewhat.
We were familiar with each other looking-wise, and it kind of blew up.
Chavis.
Chavis, I empathize with him. And so, more than anything, because I always say consistently, Chavis just says things he doesn't mean. Mm-hmm. I don't know why he does it, but that's him. He does not have any ill behind it.
Are you going to get to the root of why he does this?
Yeah,
season?
He actually, we have a conversation about it, and it's interesting. You'll see.
Okay. Cleon.
Unfortunate. Cleon was sucked into what they do every season. They divide the cast, and then most people who aren't sure themselves go along with them.
Aoki.
It was more of an affirmative action type of thing, so I see why she's here and I get it, but I don't think she did the position any justice. I think we could have got someone else up.
What
do
we do with diversity and inclusion?
Yeah, inclusion. So I get it. you know.
Julius?
Annoying at this point because... He's forgetful, and you can't be as aggressive as you are when you don't remember.
Oh.
Because I remember. Right. And when you say, oh, well, he said apparently we were cool. If we weren't cool, I wouldn't have told you what Chavis and Michelle said about you behind the scenes because we've never been friends.
Gotcha.
He's contacting me for business. It's just in my phone. It's just there. And he just does not know. And when he's disrespectful intentionally, I'm not. He is. And it's like, you could be in a room with people that you don't like. That doesn't mean you have to be disrespectful.
Right.
And now that I know that about him, it won't no longer be waiting for him to try me. It'll be handled as soon as I smell that shit. Period.
B. Billy Hood?
Billy Hood. It's unfortunate, too, because I knew Billy Hood before the show, well before the show, I'm more on a professional level doing music. And when I saw him in the streets, I didn't act like I didn't know him. Mm. Hey, Billy. Mm-hmm. Even at the Wingstop, you know, all of that. I would see him at the Wingstop. I'd be like, hey, bitch, you know. I'd be betrayed, too, and say, hey, bitch, still. Uh-huh. I'm not no funny acting bitch. And so for him to be coming at us the way he's coming at us this season, and I guess...
Oh, he came in like blazing.
Yeah, he's coming. He hasn't really targeted me yet, but I get the recoil. I still get a little...
Let's talk about Loso.
Loso, annoying as well. He just wants to be seen. Because the shit that he says, none of it fucking makes sense. Like, no one has to scream they're a celebrity anything. Celebrity means it speaks for itself.
Right, you just are.
It's a reputation that is there. You either got the 5 stars or you don't. Mm-hmm. He doesn't. And so he tries to make up for it by shaking tables when I'm not around. Mm. When I'm around... This is her. Or she wants to smile. Or Melli B. We hung out in real life. This bitch been dragging me this whole time. And this bitch could legit sit with me and have a cocktail and smile. Ooh. Play games. That's crazy to me.
Dangerous.
That's insanity, bitch. I could barely even say hello to a bitch I dislike that much.
Right.
This bitch wanted to have a great time. I'm confused.
Well, I think we're going to end right there.
That was a lot.
Because it is a lot. But there's a lot to look forward to this season.
You were great.
And
it was so good to meet you.
I am super excited. And I'm excited to see your storyline. Oh, and find out what's really happening this season on The Circle NYC. Yeah.
I will have another jingle juice, please. A vodka, please.
Who's on here?
The white isn't.
Is this your friend?
No, I don't know any of these people.
Oh, cheers, Taurus, bitch.
Taurus energy, that's all that is.